오늘 자 सम्माननीय प्रधानमंत्री जी जो नेपाल जैसे एक महान देश के सम्माननीय प्रधानमंत्री जी विश्वविद्यालय के माननीय कुलपति ऑल वर्दी मेंबर ऑफ द सीनेट secretaries from the different departments of the government of Nepal, chairman UGC, honorable member NITI Aayog, or other it is planning commission in Nepal, directors, dean, and madam registrar, all the recipients, your families, and dear friends from the press. I am really honored. I am elevated to be here. And thanks to the worthy Vice Chancellor of this university who has invited me for this confirmation speech. In Jai Nepal, we enjoy excellent bilateral ties. This is not only in terms of the political, but our age-old connections of history, culture, tradition, religion, these relations are close, comprehensive and multidimensional. Although India and Nepal, we have been separated by over or around 1800 kilometers border line. But simply this is a line. But we are connected together by five states. This is a free border, and I think this is the unique example to the world of coexistence. And generally we say ये बेटी और बेटी का रिश्ता है. और कॉमन हेरिटेज, कॉमन कल्चर, कॉमन फेथ, कॉमन बिलीफ, दीज आर द ग्रेटेस्ट असेट्स ऑफ द नेशन बिटवीन इंडिया एंड नेपाल. भारत देश भगवान राम का देश, भारत देश भगवान बुद्ध का देश, and our Lord Ram is also not complete without Nepal. So we have since more than thousands of years of the history of coexistence. And then I would say that I see myself here, it seems that I am speaking from the dais of the Horticulture University. Same basis, same language. And my hearty thanks to the Honorable Prime Minister that everything is happening in Nepal. We have gone away from the local language, local food, local tradition in India. A big change we have done, that we have shifted this coat and cap with kurta, pajama and pahari topi. This we have done in our northern states. But if you see, along these similarities, we have the uniform climatic conditions. We have four endoclimatic zones, you have six. We don't have that much varying areas. Your fruits, your vegetables, your cereals, we are doing commonly. Buckwheat and barley is one of the important crops with the whole around the globe. We are celebrating it as the International Year of Millets. So you have the wealth of those millets here also. We in Himachal Pradesh, in the northwestern part of India, our state, it falls between the 340 meters to around 6,000 meters, and here it starts, I think, from 9 meters, 59 meters, to 8,848 meters. So, you have the more strength to explore. You have the more diversity to explore. So, in that way, the students, as Honorable Vice Chancellor has said today, that we are celebrating the success of our graduates and postgraduates. But I would say, this success would be incomplete unless the people living around us, the small farmers living around us, they feel that yes, today is the convocation of this university, and now a group of around 1,000 graduates and postgraduates are coming out of the institution to help them. So unless we go out from the university, we think of the stakeholders, because you and we are not representing our respective countries. We are representing the richest heritage of the world, that is the Himalaya. And this Himalaya starts from Bhutan and it goes up to the Kazakhstan and Kyrgyzstan. So we and you have the sheer responsibility to take care of the small holders of these mountainous regions. We are coming out of our institutions as graduates and postgraduates. आपने जो हिंदी में शब्द कहा निष्णात, विद्या भारती या विद्या वचस्पति, अच्छा लगा सुनकर। जब तक हम अपने रूट्स पे वापस नहीं आए, let's remember our roots, our strongest heritage, our old culture and values. You see, across the globe, 92% small holders, farmers are feeding the whole world. 92% जो छोटा किसान है, वही दुनिया को फीड कर रहा है. But we and you are being influenced by the big farms, by the big industries, by the big technology, which is beyond our reach. Yes, we do need technology. We do need big farmers. But let's not allow our small holders to leave our country, to leave our villages, to leave our small towns in search of the livelihood. And this is happening all across the world. Who will do it? You see, I have been told that average land holding in Nepal has come down to around 2 acres. Or less than 2 acres. So we have to find out the solution for a farmer of 2 acres, that yes, you can also wear pant and shirt out of these 2 acres. Usko bhi adhikar hai pant aur shirt khareedne ka. Usko bhi adhikar hai mobile khareedne ka. And if you look around the university, you will find thousands and thousands of the small farmers living here tractor farming every month, every day. So you would be a successful graduate, because the university, by virtue of its competence in academics and linking you with the small practicals, have shown you the window, the gentleman and gentlelady see outside the windows now. How the globe is looking at on agriculture, on horticulture, on fishery, on animal husbandry. It is not only simply the growing of the crops. It is a sustainable food system. How we can connect a small holder to the consumer with the principle of transparency and traceability. Organic is a big buzzword across the globe. But we from the Himachal, from a small country in the northwestern part of the India, we raise the question that if organic farming had been successful, why the small foreign farmer could not catch it? And if you see, if you have got the chance to visit the smallholders who are doing organic farming, you'll see it has become more costlier than the chemical farming. It has become more industrial driven. So can't we find an alternative where we disconnect the farmer from the external market? हमारा किसान बाजार से कुछ भी नहीं थे. And honorable Prime Minister, I'll speak what we have been doing in the small state of Himachal Pradesh. We have converted 1.5 lakh farmers to the natural farming practices. और मैं भाई के बारे में काम कर रहा हूँ कि your people are still connected with your roots. आपका राष्ट्रीय पशु गाय है. और एक छोटे से प्रदेश से हमने दुनिया को दिखाया है गाय का गोमूत्र और गोबर ये सब फसलों का ऑल एग्रोक्लाइमेटिक जोन्स इट प्रोवाइड द कंप्लीट फूड टू ग्रो द क्रॉप द फुलेस्ट प्रोडक्टिविटी. जहां केमिकल फार्मिंग से एप्पल इज अवर मेन क्रॉप एंड अंडर हाइड्रोसिटिक कंडीशन our highest productivity is 27 million ton per acre. Whereas under natural farming practices, we could produce 42 million tons of hectare apple without using any pesticides or any other fertilizers. We are talking about the sustainable development goals. We all countries are falling in NDCs. These are our commitments. So what are the alternative dear students with us? हमें पानी कम प्रयोग करना है. पानी कम होता जा रहा है. 99% of the total available water is being used for the agriculture purpose. Our soil has grown so down that 20% of the total cultivable land across the globe has been declared as a degraded land. कौन इसको वापिस लाए? And mountainous states are more vulnerable to this degradation. इसको हम कैसे वापिस लाए? Biodiversity has reduced to the minimum, below the soil and above soil. अब छोटा सा याद करिए जो मधुमक्खी या फिर सिराना होती थी, that was the important part and parcel of our family system. Now just within the village, you will find even a single or two colonies will be available in each village. There earlier, it was a part of each family. So who will pollinate our crops? Natural enemies have gone to the lowest level. So natural farming, which we have been doing in Himachal Pradesh, is the only alternative to save our farmer, to retain our smallholders within their villages, because he buys nothing from the market, he only goes and sells his produce. That's the only solution. So my humble submission or ask to the young graduates and post-graduates that look beyond our academics. How the people across the globe, they are working in the agriculture system, they are working with the farmers. And we have the example with us that many software engineers, they came back after spending 10 years, 15 years in the industries. And ultimately, when they felt that what they are selling the fertilizer, the poison to the people, to the public, to the small farmers. Now they are working for the small farmers. We have a bigger problem of the farmer creating the farm producer organizations. We have the bigger problem of the connecting the farmers with the consumer based on the principle of the transparency and reciprocity. कितने का फार्मर से खरीदा, मार्केट में कितने का बिका और किसान को वापस कितना दिया। We are working on sustainable diversification of the crops. एक ही समय में एक ही छोटे किसान के पास 8 और 10 फसल होंगे। So our target is to elevate the soil organic carbon from average 0.5 and 0.6 to 1 in next 10 years. India has to develop